Well, welcome to another episode of Full Steam Ahead. I'm Miss Linda. I'm the head of Children's Services here at the Greenwood Public Library. And today we are going to be making nature journals. There's a lot of wonderful things going on outside, and I have a garden going strong, and we've been walking at night through the parks and stuff. And so I've really noticed a lot of wildlife and a lot of plant life. And I thought, what a really great way to document some of the things that I have been seeing. So I made a little nature journal. See, it's got a little spiffy cover on it. And you open it up, it's got just this blank pages you can fill. So we're just making a book, basically. I'll show you one. This is a little tomato plant from the backyard garden, right? So you use a nature journal basically to document like what you've seen. You can draw in it. I always encourage people to draw and make their own drawings of the plants and wildlife they see. But you can just make little notes. You can collect specimens. You could do whatever, tape them or glue them in here. So we're going to make one that you can just very handily take with you. There are a lot of different ways to make booklets. We're going to do one that's fairly simple and I hope straightforward. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to need some paper. So I just took some basic copy paper and I cut it in half. Actually, I trimmed this one a little bit because my original cover was not quite as big. But you can just take an 8.5 by 11 piece of copy paper and you can cut it. I just trimmed it so the edges are really nice and neat, right, along the line. And I am going to put a little bit of glue along that. And I'm going to try not to drip it all over. Now you'll see I have a clip holding it in place, all right? So, and usually I'm doing this over a tablecloth or a placemat or something so that I'm not dripping glue on things. And I'm flying solo today. So I'm just going to put a little bit of glue right along the edges. I just want to give you the idea. And then I take my little Q-tip and I'm just going to spread that glue. All right. Now I'll probably go back and I would put some more on that because I want a nice heavy coat of glue so that all those pages are caught. I actually will go a little bit over the top and the bottom with the glue too. And then I'm going to press it. At home, when I do this at home, I usually put it between maybe some old magazines or an old book. You'll want to be careful if you're laying something here to keep it flat and in place, not to actually put the book or the magazine right over where that wet glue line is, or you'll have an addition to your nature journal you may not want. All right. So that's the first simple part about this. I'm going to lay this over to the side so I don't get glue all over the place. Here we go. And I actually have one that I made already. It's already glued together. I let this dry overnight. One of the things you can do if you want to help keep this binding in place again is sometimes I cut just a small piece of paper the same length, right? Just like that. And I'm going to put a little bit of glue on this. I'm using glue stick right now. All right. What I did before is I just put this on and kind of folded it and creased it where I knew I wanted, where I wanted the fold to be, because I wanted to go all the way around. This is just a nice way to kind of keep it bound. Lay that right on that crease. Let's see how well I can do that. Not too bad. There we go. I'm just going to bring it up and fold it over. Okay. And the big thing is to crease it along that back, because that's where you want to put some extra glue, probably, is right there along that spine. This is called the book spine. Okay. So that makes it a little bit nicer, neater. You could also do this with masking tape or book tape if you wanted to. It's a little bit easier than glue sometimes, and it probably sticks a little better. All right, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a cover for our book. I did this one. I'm just using some of that decorative paper you get from the hobby store, the craft store. And it's just, these are 12 by 12 sheets. Now, you can use gift wrap, you can use paper bags, you can use whatever. A lot of times I have leftover gift wrap and it's kind of nice, but, and it doesn't have to be the thick stuff. This is a little bit thicker. Sometimes just regular copy paper weight is fine. So don't worry about that. Sometimes the thicker paper, which is pretty, is a little harder to fold. So, but we're going to use this. This is exactly what this turned out to be, all right? So I have a piece of paper here, and this is a piece of tag board. This is like poster board. All right, this is a 9 by 12. As a matter of fact, it's exactly the same width as happily as my decorative cover paper, which makes this a little bit easier, right? So all I'm going to do is actually just glue my tag board. Wow, this is a way to run through a glue stick too. You can use regular glue, but just for purposes today, this is a little bit simpler to do. All right, put my glue over here. And I am going to, okay, can you see that, Miss Emily? Okay. I'm just gonna glue this kind of where I've got a top and a bottom to it and the edges meet. If the edges don't meet, that's not a problem. You can always just trim, you know, because not everything is nice and neat in 12 by 12. All right. So, on the outside, on the inside, all right. And then the next thing I'm going to do is just fold this over. All right. And then fold it here on the bottom to make that nice and neat. And if you need to crease it, you can use a ruler for this project because you do have to do some measuring. I had my things already pre-measured and cut before here. But you can use a ruler. This is a nice wooden one. You can use a craft stick. You can use your thumb if you want to, and just crease that as well as you can. But sometimes just having that little bit of extra, you know, you can do the same thing with the ruler, just like that, okay? Run it over, and that just really tightens that crease up and makes things lay really nicely when you're trying to glue them, right? And again, I would just use some glue through here. All right. And then we'll press that down. And I do a little bit of glue through here. Do the same thing. And you'll notice I did not make mine even. It's okay. You can measure and make it exact if you'd like, but as long as you get those covers, that's the whole point, is just getting the front piece of your cover nice and neat. All right, now, this is a 12 by 12, so we know that it's 6 inches in the middle, right? I'm gonna go ahead and mark it just for good form's sake, so that I know that where that fold is going to be, because I want to fold this in the middle. All right. So basically, you're just going to go to your edges meet. All right. And again, you're going to crease it. I use my ruler here. All right. And that is your cover. Now, how you put these together. Ta-da. I'm going to take my book. I'm going to put some glue, fit it in. You probably will want your book to be fairly centered in here. And I'm just going to put some good glue right along the inside. A lot of times when I'm doing this, I'm not using like school glue. A lot of times I will use tacky glue just because it's a little thicker and it holds a little better, but that's okay because glue will dry. It'll be fine. I'm going to tip that in and put it over. Now, I could, if I want that to dry, I could actually, let me put my clip. Well, here. I could clip it. I could also rubber band it, you know. Sometimes a rubber band will kind of crunch a little bit on your edges. So if you just want to clip it or paper clip it, you can certainly do that. That kind of holds it in place. Again, you can just put something a little bit heavy on it and hold it till it dries. Okay, but when you open it up, when it's all dry, that's what you will have. Now, I like mine to be a little bit nicer and neater. So while this is drying, I'm going to show you what it looks like on my finished one. I did the very same thing with this. This is the front cover, which is not sticking the way it should because glue sticks sometimes rebounds on you a little bit. But anyway, you'll notice you don't see the inside like here. This one, I didn't actually have glue with me, so I taped it down, which is perfectly fine too. You can tape it and then you don't even have to worry about glue. But this is what I'm gonna do on the back because I kinda do wanna have a nice neat cover like that inside book cover. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna put some glue stick, put a little bit of glue all over that back page. All right. And then I'm just gonna pull it over and just push your weight on the whole thing and it will dry. And when you're done, you'll have an end cover in your book, right? And then your whole book will be like this. I made this one actually has several, probably a good 30 pages in it, which is not too bad. You can get fancy with this and put like little ribbons in it if you want for markers. I a lot of times will put a little marker in here with a ribbon or a piece of twine and actually tie my pencil to it because I am the world's best at dropping my pencil when I'm walking around trying to take notes. So you can do that as well. But that is essentially how a super easy way to make a nature journal. All right. And don't forget the things you put in. You want to ask questions all the time when you're walking around and looking at these things. You want to say, what am I seeing? If I'm looking at wildlife, what am I looking at in their environment? Are they alone? What are they eating? Things like that. The same thing with plants. You can look at the season. You can go back and look at the same area every season and maybe note how the changes are in your journal. And then this is kind of like a little walkthrough history then when you're going back to those places. So, all right, I hope you enjoy making one of these. Again, they're super simple to make, so you can make a nice big stack of them if you'd like. And just thank you so much for joining us today. We will see you next time.